So something that's always been interesting to me is the New World. What I mean by the New World is basically potentially what could come after the story of Attack on Titan. What comes next when we get to the ending of the narrative, when potentially everything is well and truly concluded? Is the situation between Eldians and Marlians concluded, or is it partially concluded, or is it something that's going to continue living? With the events that happen within Attack on Titan, the experience that we've gone through, with the theories that people come up with, the idea that Marlians and Eldians could coexist to some extent is very little. It almost seems impossible. These two nations, powerhouses that have been at war for so long, their ideologies are so ingrained within them. The power of Titans is such a threatening thing, but the general hatred that they somewhat have towards each other, or at least Marley having towards Eldia, is well and truly there. And it makes for a difficult turning point. It's not something that can just be forgive and forget. It's not something that they can just move on from. With how long things have been going on for, it's very hard for that to be a possibility now. So how do we change that? How do we move forward from these ingrained ideologies? How do we break this malicious construct that has been built and continuously cycling periodically for so long now? Within the story at the moment, we're building events that could lead to something massive, something that we haven't seen before. That is known as the Rumbling. The Rumbling is an event that will most likely well and truly take place, considering it's been teased so much by Isayama. For him not to use it at this point would be pretty silly. However, the context of using it, we've only known it for one thing, and that is utmost destruction. That when the Rumbling takes place, everything will be destroyed in its path. Paradise, Marley, and even whoever else. Obviously, the Rumbling's not the only thing that these people are scared of. Titans in general are a very fearsome thing, a powerhouse that no other nation has. I guess you could kind of think of it somewhat very obscure reference to nuclear warfare. If one place has nukes and another place doesn't, there's going to be a very big discrepancy between power, and those people are going to look like massive threats because they have nuclear warheads and we don't. The Titans in that concept is somewhat similar. They're very scary, and considering they've been used in such a way for so many years now, there's a lot of hatred and disingenuous feelings towards them. Even though within the portion of the story, there is quote unquote supposedly some sort of uplifting news towards them, that these Titans can push forth civilization, create city, structures, roads, building. They could be used in very fundamental, progressive ways. Now, even if that flashback or that acknowledgement of news is falsified, meaning that that wasn't true to begin with, you could well and truly use Titans to progress yourself further in the industry in any way, shape, or form. Obviously, they come off big, bad, and scary and can easily be used as some sort of weapon, but if they're used for progressing your own nation, that's well and truly a possibility. Even without the context of them supposedly being that at the beginning. We don't know the quote-unquote true history of Titans, and whether or not Ymir was potentially pushing her people forward into civilization and, you know, revolutionizing everything with the abilities of Titans. With those two things in mind, the Rumbling and the fear of Titans, you can obviously see a pattern here. That's one of the biggest things that these people are going to war against, is the fact that the Titans exist to begin with. So obviously, we have to take the Titans out, which I think is a pretty obvious thing. If you're caught up to the manga, you can well and truly see that the continued reception towards Titans and the non-existence for them is a very prevalent thing at the moment. I don't think by the end of the story there'll be Titans existing to some extent. Now, that could well and truly be wrong, and by all means, I'm excited to see how it does come to fruition, but to forge potentially some sort of peace, or some sort of peace treaty at least, the biggest threat has to be taken out of the equation. Either you share the Titans among each other, or you get rid of them completely. So one side isn't overly obnoxious with power that could easily obliterate another nation, the other side. Even that idea itself, that idea of getting rid of Titans, is such a risky thing. The hatred that Marley has for Eldia, the history that Marley and Eldia share, is so prominent, and there's nothing saying that Marley would just bend over and not try and obliterate paradise off the face of the earth. At the moment, it's a very massive stalemate. The one thing that's kind of protecting paradise and has always protected paradise is the Titans and the ability of the Rumbling. If none of that exists, Marley could well and truly swoop in and destroy them off the face of the earth. There's only the small lingering hope that they wouldn't, that they see the Titans humans as the biggest threat and not actually the people within it, but there's so much hatred there, and we know that's not the case, as their society and the children that they're raised are so ingrained into them that Eldians are evil people, that you cannot trust Eldians to any extent. That is obviously because of the history and the Titans that are within their bloodline, but it's still a massive effect. It's hard to think Marley would do that, and it's hard to think that Paradise or Eldians would give up the Titan shifting ability or the Titans in general without some sort of play at hand, which ultimately leads to the rumbling. Like I said, the rumbling has only been known as destruction, but could it be known as something else? Could it show something else? Specifically, it's very hard for me to think that Eren or anyone else could activate the rumbling and well and truly destroy Marley. Yes, Marley is filled with a lot of evil people, but it's also filled with life. People that are not part of this war to begin with. People that don't hate Eldians. People that even disagree with Marley. To think that Eren or anyone else could control the rumbling to such pinnacle precision to only obliterate a small portion of Marley is very hard to believe. So if the rumbling is activated, I can only imagine complete devastation and destruction is going to begin. However, what if it could be used in a way that shows some sort of good faith? Could become a very big eye-opener potentially for Marley specifically, and even the rest of the world. If the rest of the world has their eyes on this current situation building within the manga at the moment, the rumbling is going to be the biggest thing that people see. This is what people are scared of. If this is activated, it's going to destroy everything, and they know it. What if it's activated and it's not used to that extent though? What if for some reason Eren or anyone else activates it and uses the rumbling to self-destruct, or even just obliterate Paradise, or even just obliterate the other Titans, the massive wall Titans fighting other massive wall Titans? This would coexist with something along the lines of getting rid of the Titans specifically, that you would activate the rumbling, do your thing, etc., etc., show some sort of good faith, like, hey, I activated the rumbling, I could obliterate the world, but I'm not going to. I could destroy all my enemies at this point, but I'm not, and I want to make a deal. I won't destroy the world, and I'll get rid of Titans completely if you leave Eldians alone, if you leave Paradise alone. That in itself seems like a very far stretch, but it is some sort of an only conclusion that I can think of at the moment that maybe potentially Marley would be optimal to agree with. They don't want to get obliterated off the face of the earth. Technically, they have a lot more to lose than Eldia does. Could be gone in the face of the earth, but it's a show of good faith. So does the confliction of hatred that's been around for so many years, right? Thousands of years, overweigh the idea of potential peace? That the massive thing that Marley holds Eldians up to such a high extent in terms of hatred is the Titans specifically. If that is gone, and the showcase of the rumbling not used for destruction is also gone, could they actually come to some sort of agreement, some sort of peace treaty that would separate Marley and Eldia completely? There's always going to be tension there, that's the thing. It's not something that's just going to disappear at the end of the story. There's no way that's going to happen. I don't even think coexistence at this point within one another is even possible. But there is some sort of separation there. Paradise could go on doing its own thing, Marley could go on doing its own thing. There's still going to be a lot of racial and historical tension there, as there would be, but there could be a peace treaty in play. And it doesn't even have to be in attacked by Marley or even Paradise's perspective, but someone else's perspective, the outside world that's watching this event unfold. Like, hey, Marleyans, Eldians, you guys need to chill at the moment, okay? We've seen the good faith of the rumbling. You could have obliterated us all, but you didn't. So we're gonna oppose this treaty, all right? Yous can't attack each other. That's that. Yous go on hating each other and the history that you've upholded for so long, but now you don't have the power of Titans. And Marley, you can't just use your military power to obliterate Paradise with the face of the earth. Like, are there people out there that actually side with Eldian, that are watching this and maybe potentially see this event go down, and it's like, okay, we can side with these people. They're not that bad. Like, the power is gone, potentially. The rumbling wasn't used to obliterate anyone, so what happens next? For me, that idea, that concept is very interesting. It's not as simplistic as that, and there's always going to be some very massive details within here that make something like this potentially possible. A potential peace, to some extent, is well and truly evident, but at what cost? Exactly, I'm not entirely sure. I don't think Marley would let Eren Yeager live by the end of the story. If that is a situation or a concept that has to be in play for them to agree to a certain extent, I think Eren would oblige by it too. It sounds like it's right up his alley at the moment. He breaks everyone out of the birdcage. He himself is somewhat free. Everyone else is free to some extent, but all he needs to do is sacrifice himself alongside the Titans. Becomes a very noble thing, even after everything that he has done. He's kind of pushed pushed the people of Eldia into a new generation, into a new world that he could potentially build. Everything kind of wavers on Eren at the moment and how he thinks about the situation, because obviously he wants to push for a future that can flourish. If he activates the rumbling and uses it for destruction, it's all out war. Paradise will be destroyed. Eldians will most likely not exist. Mali will be obliterated. Innocent people will be killed. So what is the best outcome for this? Like I said, there's a lot of ideas. There's a lot of outcomes, and there's always going to be hatred there, and nothing's ever going to be as crystal clear. There's always going to be tension, and you can't realistically trust Mali either to uphold their part of the treaty to some extent. So is there something else here that we're missing? Is there another nation that's going to come into play? Is the rest of the world going to come into play? I don't entirely know. All I know right now is that by the end of the story, we should see some new world in place. A new world potentially without Titans, where Eldians can potentially thrive and flourish into something a lot more beautiful that is welcomed potentially into the modern society. They're very outdated. Or is everything going to blow up in a blaze of glory? Everything's going to be destroyed and obliterated off the face of the earth. At this point, it can go pretty much either way, and I'm very excited to see how Isayama actually handles it. So, with that being said, let me know what you think. Do you think there's going to be some sort of conclusion between Mali and Eldia, or do you think the rumbling's going to be a very destructive event that's going to obliterate a lot of different people? Let me know your thoughts. But I'm actually going to end the video off here. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.